This is the Ernie Weaver report number 523.
Down in the valley tonight, there's a man that shines with the gun in his eye and a blade shining no so bright. There's evil in the air, there's thunder in the sky, and a killer's on the bloodshot streets. On down in the tunnel with a deadly horizon, no, I swear I saw a young boy down in the gutter, he was starting to foam in the heat.
This is Ernie Weaver, and I'm standing in front of the house that Meatloaf built. That's right, Meatloaf. Let's do that. This is Ernie Weaver.
I don't want to go to another telephone. I want to use this one. You ain't your limo broke down. You wouldn't want to go to another.
We're going to be looking into the life of this young man, finding out all about him. What is he all about? Why is this man so popular in Europe? How and why has he sold 11 million albums?
Some people in New York are nice. Jerk.
Gotta be damned to know I wanna be damned. Gotta be damned to know I wanna be damned. Dancing through the night, dancing through the night, dancing through the night.
I'm in the pickup truck. I didn't want to go in the damn limo to start with. I wanted the pickup truck. Nobody will ever listen to me when I'm talking to him. Give me the pickup truck, okay?
We're going
to
do an in-depth interview, following his every move, looking into every nook and cranny, digging deep. Questions and answers on the Ernie Weaver Report. Okay, so let's get on.
So we gotta make the most of our one night together. When it's over, you go. We'll both be so alone.
Everybody hates papaya. I personally despise papaya. Especially on papaya day.
Look. You've been doing great. I've been giving you all these gold stars.
Tomorrow.
tomorrow, Marvin, is Watermelon Day. Watermelon Day. In just 6 days, it'll be Bagel Day. Bagel Day, Marvin. You'll be fine. Listen. Meatloaf. Your favorite, a bat out of hell. Will you do your meatloaf for me? Oh, come on. Do your meatloaf for me, huh? Listen. Louder. Come on, Marvin.
My son says this is Meatloaf. Are you really Meatloaf?
Oh, yeah.
Isn't that terrific?
Is this your dad?
Would you sign this for both of us, okay? This is Andrew, and I'm Woody.
It's all right.
Yeah.
Thank Later, you very Woody. Much.
Okay.
Andrew? Who is he?
Meatloaf.
Oh. Yo, Jennifer, where's David?
Just a moment, sir. I just came from a concert at Lincoln Center. Now, we played Beethoven all day. I'm sick of playing. Let me show you. Hey, I can
Judy, where's David? Where's Al?
Nicky, get him some coffee.
Hi, Jay. Hi, Nick. Hi, Bonnie. Judy, where's David? Where's Al?
This will be a minute. Walter?
David.
How you doing?
Oh, it's gonna be
Dave.
Great.
One second.
Yeah. Right.
David?
Yeah.
It's your mom.
My mom. All right, hold up my call. Walter, David? Hold on just a second. I just gotta take this quick call. Vinny, one second. Hey, JJ, do me a favor. Hold on just a second. It's just my mom. Mom? Mom, hold on just a half a second. Hello, Walter? Yeah. I'll have to call you back. Neat. I'll be right with you. Just a quarter of a second. Hello, Mom?
Dave!
Mom? Hi. How are you? Yeah. Oh, I'm all excited about it.
Dave, it's CBS Japan on 5. It's Mr. Ono.
Mom, I'll call you back. This is real important.
Al!
Neat. And I just... Hold on a second. Neat, you're looking great. I'll get back to you in a second. No, I know. You look, he's a hard guy to deal with. He's trying to, you know, he considers himself an artist. And we have to...
Al!
Hold on. Hey, Meat, I'm trying to take care of business. Please. Hold on a few minutes. Nothing's that important. It can't wait.
From the Far East. Keep your fingers off the wall.
David!
What's that?
I can't believe it.
This is it. I got it. Mr. Ono, Meat. Budokan, 8 nights. My mom on one.
What about the T-shirt?
Mom, Budokan, 8 nights. Budokan, the meatloaf, 8 nights. You know what that means? Al, 8 nights in Budokan.
Meat,
you're banging your head against the door. 8 nights for Budokan.
What about the T-shirt?
T-shirts are no problem. Is it cool?
T-shirts are money.
T-shirts
are
money.
He's
involved.
Yeah, come on, sir.
David!
Ow! Me, for crying out loud, it's been 8 nights I've told you.
Mom, 8 nights of Budokan is very important.
Okay, sorry, that's fine. I'll talk to you.
Sorry, Jim. I don't know where.
I don't want. I read this stuff. Press handout. I read that. I saw the bar. I was in the bar.
You been?
Listen, you can't
interview
him. Like,
hey, Richard,
down
you look wonderful. Listen, you got to go downstairs with me.
Jim,
listen,
Jerome,
I'm telling
from
you,
people,
Judy is down there in an army helmet,
is here.
And David and
he
Al are in their baseball
to
uniforms.
You. Come on, me.
Listen, I'm telling
we
you.
Only got a very
and
little
and there's
time
cockroaches
here.
Down
Jim
there.
Jim Jerome from People Magazine
movie.
And me.
Oh, there you go. Hi, Jim.
Yes.
You've been off the road now for a couple of years. Since 78.
Hi, Lester. What? You what? Eric, please. Eric. Lester, I can't deal with this right now, Lester. Look, I love you. I'll call you back in 15 minutes.
I
just need you just for a second. I just need you just for a second to do some background things with Eric. Just be right back, Kevin. Sorry.
All I wanted was a background check.
I'm coming. Just a minute.
Yeah, I'm a very busy man, too. You know, they told me that if I came out here, we were going to get this.
Eric needs some help on the background.
Me, does that part go, I wanna go on the red and I wanna go on the green.
You are a marvelous
on the word go.
Richard, help!
The background singer? No, that's my girlfriend.
Do you like the white one on this meat, or do you like the black one? I like this. It's a very clean thing. I think the print kind of jumps out. I don't know. Do you like it? Do you like these, though? Do you like these? I just got these a day. Do you like them? I don't know. God, Jim Jerome, come on. We gotta talk to Jim Jerome. We got 5 minutes with Jim Jerome. Yes, you can. It just take a minute. Just ask a couple of questions, a couple of answers.
Excuse me, I didn't mean to go away like
listen,
that.
Listen, Bad Out of Hell, great album, debut album, sold over 10 million. You come back with a follow-up a couple years
later. Fabulous idea, Jim. I don't know what you're going to do.
If you sell
we
only
could
three,
do a press conference to promote
if you sell
the record.
3 and 4 million, how do you define
now, Susan
success
is from Epic
at this
here. She's here right now. Jim, it'll take just a minute. Just a minute.
If you sell
only three. Please don't, Susan. Please don't, Susan.
Me and you, and me, you want to.
I should finish something, you know.
Darling, listen, Lester. What do you think? The shrink wrap, the color of my nail polish.
If I don't talk to the guy,
the color of my nail. Look, look like the color of my nail.
Brink!
Brink!
Brink! Brink! Yo, me!
Hey,
yo,
Brink. Hey, how you doing, man? You gotta see security I got. You gotta see security I got. You won't believe this. Yo, guys, let's go. Put it out here. Look at these guys. We got Sarge. We got Phil. We got Lou. We got Big Lou. We got Freaky Phil. We got Mo, Larry, Curly. We got Abdul.
We have a schedule.
We got Jonah. We got Fernando. We got Jose.
Please, just 10 minutes. Do the interview with Jim, please. Please, me, I beg you. Please.
I'm sorry. If you don't bother you, if I don't bother you, I gotta go home. I gotta go home.
Me, please.
Jim,
please.
Excuse me.
Me,
Debbie, accept my apologies.
Please,
please,
me. Please, please.
I gotta go.
Please.
I gotta go.
So you don't like violins, right? Well, how about guitars, huh?
Let's go to Lover for both of us.
Okay.
Lover! Lover! That's it, Lover. Very good. Okay, now, it's a high fly. Catch this one there. Okay, Mar, there you go.
Excuse me.
Now,
would you and your friend like to play a little catch with my son Andrew and me?
Yeah, sure, why not? We'll play catch with him.
Great. Great, that'll be fun. Okay. Ready, okay, Andrew?
Throw her in.
Get ready.
Come on, Mar, you can do it.
Okay,
catch
here you go.
Catch the ball, Mar.
There you go.
You got it. You got it. That's the way to go.
Get ready, Andrew.
Fire in here. Fire in here.
Fun.
You gotta throw a little harder.
Okay,
there,
now
Mar.
Get ready. Here we go.
There
Atta
you
boy.
Go.
Good
there
for you.
Go.
Nice
way
one.
Go,
way to go.
Go.
Here
go
you go.
There.
Oh,
you gotta
kind of
clutch it, Marv. You gotta clutch the ball. Use both hands. Two hands on the ball. Throw her in there, Marv.
Go ahead and throw.
Quicker if you throw it, Marv.
What's the matter?
Where'd you get this ball?
That's my ball.
It's my son Andrew's.
Yeah, oh, it's his meatloaf on it. Did he sign it to
oh,
the store?
Well, you see, he's our neighbor. We live right up there, and we're very close friends.
Yeah, where do you live?
Right up the hill here.
It's been great knowing you, and it's really great playing catch, and we got to go now. Come on, look.
We haven't had a chance to bat or anything. Well, they stayed around longer than your mother.
Me. Excuse me, but is this the home of Meatloaf?
Well, these are his offices. They're...
Well, would it be possible for us to see Meatloaf?
No, he's at rehearsal.
Well, after rehearsal,
it's
can we see him? You see, my brother, Marvin...
Where's the limo?
The limo broke down.
The limo broke down?
He's a big guy.
Well, where's my car?
You don't have a car.
I don't have a car?
No.
Oh, that's great. I don't have a car, no limo.
From one big guy to another, he'd help him out.
Do you fellows have a car?
Yeah, we've got a car.
Do you think you could give me a lift?
Well, we want to meet Meatloaf.
You might be able to meet Meatloaf.
Oh, you mean, oh, to take you to Meatloaf?
Yeah,
at the rehearsal.
Rehearsal.
Over there we're going to meet Meatloaf.
You see Meatloaf.
Take a walk.
Move. Move.
jerks. Move!
You guys look ridiculous. I wouldn't let you in even if you had a pass. And don't come back. Get me a little Woody and go surfing.
Have a nice day.
Yeah, same to you, buddy. Have a nice day.
I'm sorry. There's nothing really there. It's just kind of a habit.
Are we rolling, Sid?
Yeah, we're rolling.
The Ernie Weaver Report. As promised, we were going to bring you Meatloaf. He's here right now. We said we were going to dig into his past, look into every nook and cranny, go into this young man's life and find out what makes him tick. Well, he's here now, and we're going to ask him some searching questions. See what he's all about. And later on, maybe we'll even sing. Well, good morning, Meatloaf.
Good morning.
May I call you Meat?
What?
May I call you Meat?
Sure, Ernie.
Fine. Now that we're on a first-name basis, let's ask you, Meat. Tell us, how did it all begin? Where did this all start? Where did this singing start, this life of music? Where did it generate from? What were its origins?
Would you like for me to tell you?
Yes.
Oh, okay, great. Well, I grew up a family of seven, and I was bigger than everybody else in the family, including my mother and my father. Even at the age of 11. And.
Are we ready, children?
Yes, Miss Mark.
All right, now, listen to this note.
I was bigger than the other kids, too. And they used to like to hear me sing.
We are singing, and you are singing something quite different. Would you mind singing with us?
I did sing,
That's not what I heard, M.L. Would you mind trying again?
Yes, Miss Ross.
Thank you. Children, once again. Class. And when you learn to mind me, then you can come back in again. Do you hear? And you just stay out here until I'm ready to call for you again. Do you hear what I said? Now you just stay out here until I'm ready for you.
Basically, your normal childhood, you know, and, I mean, I always knew I wanted to sing.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, fine young people, Ernie Weaver first. Now, we have here your Meatloaf's new album. Interestingly enough, Meatloaf. On the cover is a picture of a...
Ernie, it's actually called Dead Ringer.
You're going to have to use the antenna.
Oh, Dead Ringer, I see that on the album.
Try that.
No, it's actually on the other side, and it's also...
We don't want to miss any of it.
It's on the edge there. See?
All right.
You
right
gotta
on
get
the
rest of it, too. Get the rest.
Boy, you're a real funny guy.
I understand you're from Louisiana, is that right?
No, I'm from Texas.
Texas, right. Oh, Texas. Texas. Oh, my heart really is in Texas. I have a lot of my family is from Texas and my background, that's really nice to find out.
Unstack the first thing now. That's it,
Young man.
Now hold the others out. Give me others. Hey, stop. Oh,
Another turn, the way it was. You had it before. Now do the other. Get the other. Spread them out as much as possible. As I say, hold it, hold it. Stop. 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 Well, it's not working. Well, try putting something out the window. Make it long. Now hold it, hold it. Well, put the other thing up. Put the other hand up.
Right.
Yeah.
I have a grandmother from Texas.
Really?
Yes.
Well, it's real interesting, Ernie. Do you know where in Texas?
Somewhere around the Napa Valley, I think. I think that's
what it's called. Ernie, the Napa Valley is in California.
Right. Well, that's where my family's from, the Napa Valley.
Not Texas.
But I do have a strong feeling, affinity for Texas, and I've always liked people from Texas. They have big hearts there.
It doesn't work right. Put some more of it out the window. Make it as long as possible.
Hey, what's going on?
I'm Gonna Love Her for Both of Us is the name of the song we're going to sing.
I've got enough love for both of us.
No, Ernie. Watch here. I'm going to love her for both of us.
I'm going to love both of us.
No, her for both of us.
I'm going to love her for both of us.
Right.
Why don't you just go up there and... tickle those tonsils.
Marvin, he's gonna sing! Hurry up, do it!
And now, Meatloaf singing Big Enough for Both of Us.
It's getting darker, you see, and that's a... Marvin! Wait.
Rolling Stone magazine is here. They want to do an interview.
Also,
can you approve the backstage passes? You want to...
Would you shut up, you're obsessive bastard!
Shut up! Wait till you see the interior of the plane. It's a complete Hawaiian luau.
Where's David? Where's Al?
They're down in Billy's office. They're having a private meeting. They said not to be disturbed.
Meet?
Meet. Please. Please, no. Please, not to be disturbed.
Meet.
Meet. There is a very important meeting going on in there. It is a very private meeting. I gave my personal assurances that no one would disturb them. It is about your tour. It is about your life, your destiny. I gave them my word. Please. What the hell are you playing that mindless, stupid game for? There are a lot of things to be discussed. There are a lot of preparations that have to be made. What about the kickoff party? I think a lot of people are waiting for it. I think a lot of people deserve it. I think we owe it to them. What in the hell is going on here? Meet, what about the party?
Frank.
You're not thinking of the way the man used to roll, so he's got to...
I know.
It's his party.
I know. It's...
Give him a break.
What am I going to do? I have to have him or Chris Christie.
Burn,
right here. Who wants a hamburger? We got it right here. Who else?
Meat.
Who else?
Me?
You want a hamburger?
I'm sorry to say this, but we have an interview in 1 hour in the city with Chris Christie, right? In an hour. Chris Christie is going to interview in an hour. Would you come with me, please, Meat? I know this is your party, and it's the kickoff party. I feel very... I've called it up. It's my responsibility. I got the date switched. We have an interview date right now with Chris Christie in 1 hour. Can you come, please?
You know what? Can I have a bun? Please, 10 things.
Please,
10. Please, okay? No.
Oh, me, come on. Break.
Guess what? I'm not going.
Come on, me.
I'm not going.
Get it. Get it, Jack. Come on. I'm not going. Freddy, come on and help me take him away now.
Okay,
quiet.
You have an hour to get there.
Please, me. I'm sorry. I apologize.
Quiet.
Fine.
Please.
Fine.
Let's go. Come on. It won't take long.
No smoking around me.
See you later. All
right. Chris, I don't like smoke.
You're standing in a pile of smoke right now.
But I don't like your smoke!
All right. Come Come on, Meat. I'm very sorry about this. It's a lovely party, I know, and you've worked very hard to make it so. And I really want to.
Come on, I'm going to handle it. Just relax.
Really that important? Huh?
Chris Christie is a very important guy for you to interview with. I think so, yes. I think it would be very good for the album.
All right, I'll go. Come on. There you go.
You're beautiful.
Don't say that.
You are.
Don't say that.
Thanks a lot.
There you go.
I love you. Good to see you.
Chris.
Hey, there he is. Meat.
Okay, Chris, you got the album, and Meat, I'll get you back to the party as soon as I can. Thanks a lot.
Chris, I love you. Cheers, okay, we have a public service announcement. It's 4:30 in the afternoon. Do you know where Perry Como is?
Okay, I have a guest in the studio today. The Meat Man is here with us. Meatloaf himself is right here with me. How are you doing?
Hey, we're rocking and rolling with Chris
Christie, aren't we?
This is my old man. We went to summer camp together one time a long time ago.
H-I-A-W-A-T-H-A, Hiawatha. The Red Wings, the rock and roll Red Wings.
That right.
Rock and roll.
Listen, getting down to business here, we have what you call a new album here
that you just put out here. Yeah, it's happening.
So how do you feel about this thing?
I feel great about it. Listen, not only is this a record.
You get a record in here, see like this record
There's
here?
There's a record in
and
there.
And you get the lyrics on this.
The lyrics
But you also
there.
Get the cover, which the you can cover. Put on your head. I get it on my head, and you can make a hat out of it.
It's a hat, folks.
Come
we
on,
got
Chris,
a hat
put it on,
here.
Put it on.
The album goes on your head, and ladies and gentlemen, you got a hat.
Got the lyrics, you can read the lyrics and wear the hat. And at the same time, you can listen
you
to the record.
Album. You can eat it.
No, you don't eat it, because my name is Meat.
No, you can't eat it. You can use
you
it
never
as a
grew
frisbee.
Up.
So for the price of the whole thing,
up.
You get the album, you get the words right here. We got Read 'em and Bleep.
No, man.
Read 'em and Bleep.
Read 'em and Weep.
Oh,
check it out. Weep my lips.
Read 'em and Weep. Read 'em and Bleep. Weep.
It
doesn't matter.
You got
it's hot. Go and get one. But let's get down to some more business here.
Chris, yo, let's take these silly hats off.
You got a concert coming up real soon.
Oh, yeah, Friday night.
Friday night for all of you out there who have nothing to do, or if you do have something to do, don't do it. And go to this concert here, and we got the ticket prices down here at $10.50, $11.50. Woo! $11.50 and lottery winners only, man. You can't afford that stuff down front. It's for the heavyweight stuff. That's for the Rockefeller crowd. That's expensive stuff, but my
yeah,
man is worth it. Maybe one of these days you're going to be just strolling through the park and the guy is going to be there playing for free. For all we know, it could happen, but maybe not.
Guess
not
what, Chris?
Folks.
Chris, Friday night, the concert
is free.
For you, for me, for them, rock and roll is free Friday night.
You got it, you rock and roll. You rock and roll mothers. We're going to have a free concert Friday night. If you're holding tickets now, it is free. If you ain't got tickets, you better line up and get them. Come on, let's go.
It's apocalypse now. You got a free concert.
But you better wait. Hold it, Chris. Hold it. Everybody has got to come in. It's got to wear the album cover.
You
to
wear
get
a
in
hat.
As a hat.
You get in for free. There's no money at this.
You
one.
Wear the album
Just
cover as a hat. You get in for free.
You can't do a free concert.
Listen to me, man. It's free. It's no money. It's rock and roll. It's free.
But you did, Jack.
So you're in the swimming pool. Why don't you swim for it? You're in trouble now, Jack. Not me. I'm still going to do my show.
That's good.
It's fine. Yes, it's fine.
Thank you. 73 and 74, Tony. Good, right? Next.
Tell you weren't good enough company because they wouldn't take them off when you were there, right?
But we do one thing.
You're a stand. Oh, I was wondering what you were doing.
Gentlemen, Miss Pamela Moore. Straight to the top. Oh, God, the ceiling.
Davey and Steve.
Is Davey and Steve and them not there? Be in here in Dead Ringer. Come in behind us and get in behind us like we're a gang in a bar.
Full house, we're gonna try to get everybody in.
Ladies and gentlemen, Meatloaf!
Album covers on our head.
Get it.
Who knew? Marvin, don't worry. We'll get in there. We'll see him. We will. Let's go.
Letting up at all, he's going to try for the second. The ball is bobbled out in center, and here comes the throw, and what a throw!
gonna slide in head first. Here he comes. He's out. No, wait, safe at second base. This kid really makes things happen out there. Batter steps up to the plate. Here's the pitch, and he's going, and what a jump he's got. He's trying for third. Here's the throw. It's in the dirt. Safe at third. Holy cow, stolen base. Taking a pretty big lead out there, almost scaring him to try and pick him off. Pitcher glances over, winds up, and it's butted down the third baseline. The suicide squeeze is on. Here he comes, squeeze play, it's going to be close. Here's the throw, here's the play at the plate. Holy cow, I think he's going to make it.
Stop right there!
Promise land, calling in the poor boys on the line.
Ooh,
tell the folks back home.
You got to be me to be for the people, so I'm gonna get lost.
till the rock and roll. This is the promised land, calling and the poor boy is on the line. Tell the folks back home, this is the promised land, calling and the poor boy is on the line.
I did 3 yesterday. I did 7 the day before. They were lined up outside the hotel in Toronto. I woke up at 6 a.m. and got on loop in Chicago. I'm halfway to Baltimore, and you want me to do something else. What exactly are you trying to tell me?
All I am saying is that we will keep it now down to a minimum of radio interviews. All I want is just one more little bitty little TV show with you.
Which one?
Ernie Weaver.
Did the Ernie Weaver show.
I know you did the Ernie Weaver show. That's a month ago, but they loved you. They flipped out. They want you back again, and they're very big. They're getting very big.
If you think for 1 second that I'm getting on a plane going to New York for the Ernie Weaver show, you're crazy. I did 3 shows in a row. I got one more tonight. I got to do a sound check, and I'm not getting on a plane. I got 2 days off after today, and I'm going to sleep.
Did I say that? Did I say that?
No, but you insinuated
did it. Did I say that?
No, you insinuated that I got to get on a plane and go to New York to do the Ernie
Weaver
show.
They will
I love
come
Ernie
to you, darling. They're going to come backstage.
You call me darling one more time and I'll punch you in the face.
I'll call you booty tootie. I'll call you anything. Look at darling.
When?
They're bringing a remote
when?
Crew.
When?
Just after.
Well, watch my lips. I say when. When are they coming?
Tonight.
Ernie Weaver show's here for the interview.
Meet Ernie Weaver's out there.
I heard it.
I'm going to let him in.
Come on in, Ernie.
Thank you.
Meet, it's
thank
Ernie Weaver's show. Ernie?
Yeah. Richard. Hi, Meet. Richard, you told me after the show.
I did not. I said it was backstage, not after the show.
It's me, Ernie Weaver. Meet. Hi.
Hi,
sorry,
Ernie.
I hope I haven't bothered you.
Oh, not at all, Ernie.
How do you like that Texas motif?
I've never seen anything more beautiful in my entire life, Ernie.
Thanks. Well, I was inspired by your story, and my sponsors and everyone was so excited by our last show that they insisted that I come out here.
Oh, they insisted.
Yeah.
Oh, that's great, Ernie.
I had no say in it or anything. I just had to come out here and get some more of your story. And are we ready, Sid? If we can.
Yeah, right. We're rolling.
This is the Ernie Weaver Report. I'm here in Meatloaf's dressing room now, and I'm going to interview him some more, get some more background, some more information about this young man's life. Hi, Meat.
Hi, Ernie.
Well, everyone enjoyed the last show so much, and we're all interested in many things about you, but first I'd like to start and ask you, man to man, is it true that is that the whole story that you told us the last time? The whole true story of your origins and your background and how you got started in singing? Is that the whole story?
As a matter of fact, Ernie, none of that was true.
I see. Well, you've heard it here on the Ernie Weaver Report. What is the full, real story? How did this all begin? How did this begin?
You really want to know?
Yes, I sure do.
Well, when I was a kid, I was really into bikes. And I remember when I was 11, I had this big red Schwinn bike.
It's a bike. Oh, these are nice tires.
Oh, look at the selection.
Hurry up! You're gonna be late for school!
Okay, Mama! Hey, guys, we're gonna be late for school. We better go. Mom says we're gonna be late.
16. Like a miracle. I could sing. In fact, I've been singing ever since then.
A miracle, folks. Straight from the words of Meatloaf. Well, now, Meat, how about your concert tour?
Ernie, I'm sorry, but that's all the time we have.
I've just barely got started.
I'm sorry, Ernie. I think it went very, very well, though.
Thank you.
That is, in fact, it, Ernie.
Let's go.
Yeah, thanks. I think it was wonderful.
It's a wrap on the video. Let's go.
Okay.
Well,
thanks a lot. And I think
I can't ask him anymore.
Oh, I think he's wonderful.
See you later.
Well, I'm not really finished.
Oh, that's okay, Ernie.
You could get some live footage of him at the concert.
You were something to see, so very young and low. And I still don't believe the way you turned on me. There was a girl that I knew. I gave you somewhere to live and then somebody to love. You gave me nothing but trouble, man, I've been such a fool. You gave me nothing at all, and let me give it to you. You talked me out of it through, man, let me try it on you.
Once again, coming to you on television live from Canton, Indiana, Ohio. The crowd is just loving it, ladies and gentlemen. I'm right here in the midst of them, and he's singing another of his great numbers, I Won't Come Back If You Kill Me. Another Ernie Weaver first, ladies and gentlemen.
Kill you if you don't come back.
Thank you.
sand on the beach. We're dreaming of boys and still just out of reach. And I saw the cheerleaders down on the track. But this was like diamonds with sweat on their backs. And I saw the girls and the gangs on the street. They're looking for danger and they're holding their peace. And I saw the girls playing late after school. They're playing on fire and know they're playing it cool.
Chocolate chip cookies. Chocolate chip. Teddy, it's on the right. There's got to be some pie here.
There's got to be some blueberry pie. There's got to be some blueberry pie or something.
Pretzel. I've got some pretzel.
Teddy, it's not pie. Apple pie.
I got my cherry pie.
Macaroni salad.
Blueberry pie.
Potato salad.
Teddy,
how about meat? You need some protein. You know you passed
mince meat pie, man. Corn pie.
Some protein.
Pumpkin pie. All-American apple.
I got salad.
Doesn't anybody understand the craving?
Me. What's the matter? Do you like my glasses?
I want pie. It's supposed to be on the rider. Pie.
Pie? You want some country pie?
Urban pie.
I got to get some pie, too. I got to get some pie. I'll be back. I gotta go get some pie. Pie.
What a rage.
Having some pie.
Many is pie.
Come on, Frank. Come on, Freddy.
I hope he's all right.
Meat! Meat! Open the door! Meat, are you all right? Meat! Are you all right, Meat?
Oh, for God's sake, thank God you're all right. Where have you been, Donnie? Where have you been?
My back's killing me, man.
I'm sleeping
in this truck.
Oh, get out of the truck, darling. Get out of the truck and come and get on the bus. My Lord, we've got private investigators all over the place looking for you. The police have been looking for you.
Somebody got me out of this truck. I was looking for pie.
Why did you leave?
I ain't got pie.
You wanted for pie? What kind of pie, darling? I'll get you a piece of pie anytime you want.
thing when I compare a picture of you. I don't know who you are,
what you do,
or where you go
when you're not around.
I don't know anything about you, baby.
But you're everything I dream of.
I don't know who you are,
but you're a real dead ring of love. A real dead.
Richard, just wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Listen. I dreamed I was being followed.
Followed?
Yeah, I dreamed I was being followed. It was horrible. I dreamed. I was being followed. We get a pencil paper. Come on. I gotta write this all down. I gotta write this down. Write it down. Here we go. You got it? You ready? One. I dreamed I was being followed. It was by this guy and another guy. They're laughing, and no one of them laughing, one of them. And all I know is I was being followed. Richard, are you getting all the... Excuse me. I got it. Excuse me.
What's the matter?
Nothing. Nothing. Nothing, Richard. You just go back to sleep, okay?
All right.
Hey, can't this bus go any faster? Brink.
Why?
Wake up. Real. He's not real. Somebody followed me. That's right. Okay. Good night. Good night, Mr. Moose.
Good night.
That's right. Go back to sleep.
And we're flagging it down. Can you let us in?
Open the door.
Sorry to bother you like this. I have to speak to Mr. Money or Mr.
Hey,
sorry,
Rich.
Mr.
Just a minute, babe. Hey, Rich. Mr. Ernie Weaver's here, man.
Who?
Ernie Weaver.
Ernie Weaver, yes. You remember from the Ernie Weaver show? Ernie Weaver show. Yes.
Hi, Ernie.
Hi.
Ernie Weaver,
yes. Hi. Mr. Money, good to see you again. I didn't finish my interview with Mr. Meatloaf. I'd like to finish it now, if possible.
Weaver, Ernie.
Yes.
Tonight. At the concert.
At the concert.
Backstage?
Backstage.
More dramatic?
More dramatic, yes. Oh, at the back... Oh, backstage at the concert,
at
tonight.
The concert.
Oh, yes. We could do that tonight.
Ernie.
Yes.
Later.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Mr. Money. Okay. I'll see you tonight at the concert.
Later. See you later.
Okay.
How can you tune guitars with that stuff going on? Trying to tune guitars in here!
Hold on.
Oh, I gotta get this done in here!
Well, we gotta get this done out here!
Well.
2 minutes!
Ward, you got Ernie Weaver, some Brody's with, and a guy with a camera behind him. So check them out halfway down there, all right?
All right.
And when you get a chance, come down here and spell me. We have been here all night.
Okay.
Oh, they're right there, you two. Where the hell you think you're going?
Well, we're just going right
in. No. This is the stage door. You can't come in here. You got to go around the front and give the guy your ticket, all right? The two of you. The two of you. No, what are you looking at?
Stage door.
Take him and go up front.
Okay.
No. Go on.
We didn't
all right?
know it was the stage
door. Go out front, the glass doors, give the guy your ticket. You got a ticket?
Yeah.
All right. Go on. Up front.
Come on, Marvin.
Sorry.
Okay.
Yep. He's in his dressing room? Okay. He's in his dressing room.
Meat, can I talk to you about the hats, Meat? Do you like the yellow jumping off the black, or do you like the white, Meat? We're talking about hats.
John, what do you like? Do you like the yellow coming off the black, or do you like the white?
And I want you to walk out there with pride. You understand? You're on the Meatloaf team now. You are on the Meatloaf team.
Hold on. Where are you going?
Oh, well, we're just going backstage. You know who this is, don't you?
Thank
you.
I have no idea who this is.
You don't? And you call yourself in the rock musical business?
I can't let you in. You have a backstage pass or anything?
Oh, yeah, we got a backstage pass. We were given backstage passes.
You have them on you? You're supposed to be wearing them.
I left them in the hotel. But we don't have time. You see, we have a big interview. He has to interview Meatloaf.
I can't let you in the building without a backstage pass. I'm sorry.
But they're in the hotel!
I cannot let you backstage without a pass. You're going to have to go back and get your backstage passes before I let you in the building. Okay? You go get them and I'll let you in.
That's a good idea, to go get the passes.
Great.
I don't want to see any smoking. I don't want to see any drinking. Meatloaf, you don't like smoking.
Joe Ward, how are you doing?
Hi, Peter. What's up?
Nothing much. It's quiet.
Really quiet, huh? It's been the fun back here. Uh-oh, hold on. I cannot let you back here. Brink does not want to see you at all. I cannot let you back here. Pete, I gotta take care of this. I'll be right back, okay?
I got you.
Yeah, Teddy, you gotta see what Ward's got his hands on out here.
Hey! Where have you been? They've been waiting 2 hours for this.
Oh.
Get it inside. Hurry up.
Yeah, okay, right away.
Where's your pass?
Oh, I guess I...
You guys are always losing them, honest to God.
Yeah, I keep losing
them. Try and
hold
on to this one. Get it in.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Goodbye, sir.
Jerk.
Hey, Pete. Can you hang out some of these cases over there?
Yeah, sure.
Right. Now, as far as violence goes, I'm usually against it in general, you understand? But if things happen to get out of hand, you have to bust a few heads to keep the peace, and that's the breaks, right?
Ernie, do you want to have one of these?
Sure, I think it'd look good. I think it'd be nice. Uh-huh.
See you there. Fry!
Keep staring at me like that. I'm sorry, you know?
Could we get started?
Sure.
Okay, yeah, I guess, could I have a makeup touch-up?
Absolutely. Darlene, can you come in here, please, honey, and help Ernie
excuse
here?
Me. Sorry, I changed hats.
Okay. I mean, put me downstairs in this basement, in this boy's bathroom. About your last
this
mistake,
was
Dick.
Not my fault, Meade. I
Whose
swear
fault
to you,
was it,
I don't know. There
Who's
was a problem in
tour?
Communications, but we have to get this interview going. We have
any little
time.
Would you like some makeup?
He does not want any makeup. Thank you very much, darling.
Well, how the hell do you know, Dave? Maybe I do this.
My
time.
Name is Richard.
Hand number 10.
My name is Richard, and we have to get this interview going right away, Ernie. Are you ready?
Yeah,
darling,
ready.
Please.
I want my makeup.
Darling.
I want my makeup. Tan number 10.
Tan
number
10. Oh, tan number 10. Fine. Well, you never
want
tan.
I don't have.
You blew it this time, Dick.
Yes, I did. I'll take full responsibility.
All right, we can.
Fine, darling, that's good. Ernie, are you ready to go?
Yes, I don't wear makeup.
Please, let's go. Eric, Ted, just keep it down, please. Please, Frank, don't let anyone in the room. Go ahead.
This is the Ernie Weaver Report. This is Ernie Weaver, backstage once again with Meatloaf. Hi, Meat.
Hi, Ernie.
Last time, of course, we talked about the touching story of the young man from Texas who experienced the miraculous event of
Ernie.
How does it say?
Ernie.
The event.
I'm not from Texas, Ernie.
What?
I'm not from Texas.
You're not from Texas?
No.
Oh. Well.
I made it up.
Look at that, folks.
I'm from New York.
You're from New York?
You got it.
You're not from Texas?
No. I'm from New York.
I'm from Texas. You're from New York?
From New York.
Well, why don't we ask him what the...
You want to know how I got started, really?
Yes, let's have the real story, Meat, about your beginnings and origins.
It started on a Saturday. I remember it just like that.
Hey, what are you guys doing? Hey,
Meat,
quiet.
Am I doing this?
I'm doing an NFL!
There's somebody I want you
to meet. For a while.
It's really easy. This person is
somebody. Who are you?
Sorry, darling.
Thousands of people upstairs waiting to get this.
Kodak!
You're real. Not going crazy. Oh,
everybody get out of here!
Everybody out. Let's go. Come on, hurry up.
You Ernie Weaver, you get out of here now! Get your cameraman out of here too! Eric, get out of here!
What is the matter with him, Richard? Enough is enough. Do you know
I'm
what
going,
this
I'm
means?
Going.
No, it's back to the weather report. I'm sorry.
You stay.
Who's this guy?
That's my brother, Marvin.
Who are you?
I'm his brother, Russell. Pleased to meet you, Meade.
Glad to meet you, Russell.
You see, we've been following you around for quite a while, and we've been hoping
Whoa. You say you've been following me around?
Well, you see, my brother Marvin is a terrific singer, and a lot of people think that, you know, because he can't talk, that he can't sing, but it's not true. He's a...
You're through talking as of right now, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now you go on and get out of here, all right? Go ahead, Russ. Go ahead. Go on.
Now we leave him here.
Who is that guy?
My brother.
Marvin, right? Right? Marvin? Ooh, Marvin! Me and you are gonna do some talking, Jack. You wanna talk? You sure? Well, let's me and you talk. Come on, let's go over this way. Come on.
What's going on? Where did you get that pass?
What pass?
I know we're running a little late,
Time, the house lights are down. Meet, the band has started.
Screaming and the fires of hell, and we're down in the valley tonight. There's a man in the shadows with a gun in his eye, and the blade shining oh so bright. There's evil in the air, and there's thunder in the sky, and the killers on the bloodshot streets. And down in the tunnel with a deadly horizon, oh I swear I saw a young boy down in the gutter. He was starting to foam in the heat. Oh, burial, the only thing in this whole world, it's pure and good and right. And wherever you are and wherever you go, there's always gonna be some light. But I gotta get out, I gotta break it out now, before the final crack of dawn. So we gotta make the most of our one night together. When it's over, you know, we'll both be so alone. The gates of heaven, I'll come crawling home.